Hi there, I'm Sam from Professional Music Technology, and today we're talking about humidity and temperature levels and the effect that they can have on a guitar. Now, achieving the ideal humidity and temperature levels for a guitar, and more importantly, keeping those levels consistent, can sometimes be a little tricky. Over the course of a year, levels can change quite drastically with cold winters and hot summers, storms and heat waves, bringing with them either very dry or very humid air. And if your guitar is stored in a room that's prone to more extreme humidity and temperature levels, there's a good chance that over time, you're going to start having some problems with it. Just in case you were a little bit confused by what I'm talking about, temperature is obviously how hot or cold your room is, measured in Celsius or Fahrenheit, and humidity is the amount of water vapour that's present in the air. Luckily, it's pretty easy to keep an eye on these levels if you pick yourself up a digital hydrometer and thermometer, which are reasonably inexpensive and they're widely available either online or from a DIY store. Most experts agree that the ideal humidity level for storing an acoustic guitar is between 45 to 55% relative humidity. But as I've just mentioned, maintaining this level in your home year round can be a little difficult. So the general consensus is that a relative humidity level of between 40 to 60% is safe for storing most types of guitar. In terms of temperature, you want to keep the room that your guitar is stored in at between 21 to 25 degrees Celsius or 70 to 77 degrees Fahrenheit. So why are these levels so important? Well, as you already know, a guitar is mostly made from wood, which, unlike plastics and metals, will naturally expand and shrink depending on the moisture levels and temperatures that it's exposed to. And this can cause all manner of problems for a guitar. If your guitar is left for a long period of time in an environment that has a high moisture content or high humidity, the woods will take on more and more moisture and start to expand and swell. Telltale signs of too high a humidity level can include warping of a guitar's neck and bulging around frets. The flat top of an acoustic guitar can start to bulge as the tension of the strings pulls on the expanding wood. The glue holding the body and bridge together may start to fail. You might notice some bubbling in the finish. And the guitar itself can generally start to sound a little duller in tone as the added moisture restricts it from resonating as efficiently. Environments with low humidity levels are equally as bad for a guitar. If this is the case, you'll want to keep an eye out for symptoms such as cracks appearing in woods and lacquer, shrinking fingerboards, which means the fret ends will start to poke out of the edges, making the neck feel uncomfortable to play. And you'll often start to notice more and more extreme fret buzz and string choking as the neck contracts and starts to pull backwards. In terms of temperatures, it's the extremities that are most dangerous to a guitar, especially if it's subjected to rapid or regular temperature changes. For example, if it's stored in a room that gets very cold at night and then very hot during the day. More extreme temperatures will emphasise and accelerate any problems that are already being caused by high or low humidity levels, but they'll also bring a few problems of their own. For example, freezing conditions can ruin a guitar's finish, causing it to crack and craze, and higher temperatures will cause glues to start failing. I've lost count of the amount of acoustic guitars I've seen where the bridge has started to lift and pull away from the body because it's got too hot. Now, all of these problems can cause permanent damage to a guitar, and it can be extremely costly to repair any serious damage. But luckily, there are a few things that we can do to try and maintain more constant humidity and temperature levels in our homes to avoid some of these problems occurring. Firstly, as I mentioned earlier, pick yourself up a hydrometer and thermometer so you can keep an eye on the levels in the room that you store your guitar in. Central heating in the winter and air conditioning during the summer will dry out the air in the room, whilst cooking, boiling kettles, hot showers and drying clothes on radiators can all add up to overly high humidity levels in a home, especially if you don't have adequate ventilation. So in the case of an overly humid environment, maybe you live in an old house that's prone to getting a little cold and damp, you can use a dehumidifier to remove some of the moisture in the air, and you can avoid unnecessary condensation buildup and vapour being added back into the air by making sure that you turn on an extractor fan or crack open a couple of windows whenever you're cooking or treating yourself to a long hot bath. Going the opposite way, an electronic humidifier can help add moisture back into the room if the air is too dry. Or if you've got an acoustic guitar, we'd highly recommend investing in a sound hole humidification system. There's quite a few types available, with the most basic being a little plastic pot with a sponge inside. You wet the sponge, suspend the pot in the guitar's sound hole using the strings, and it will slowly release its moisture, keeping your guitar humidified. If the sponge dries out, simply refill the pot with water and pop it back in the sound hole again. The next step up from this is the Dodario Planet Waves Humidity Pack, which works on a similar principle, but instead of having to add water, it utilises replaceable humidifier packets that automatically either emit or absorb moisture to maintain a constant 45 to 50% relative humidity. You suspend two packs in the sound hole, place another one up by the headstock, close the case, and that's it. They create the ideal humidity level for your acoustic guitar to live in, and each pack will last up to 4 months. To add to this, Dodario also make a really cool little gadget called the Humidity Track. You leave this device in your case with your guitar, and it constantly monitors humidity levels, sending alerts to your phone via Bluetooth if levels become either too high or too low. And this is definitely something that we'd recommend if you own a high-end acoustic guitar. So even if you do manage to maintain the optimum levels in your guitar room all the year round, we've still got a few more tips to avoid any humidity or temperature based problems. So here's our list of do's and don'ts for storing your guitar. Definitely do store your guitar in a gig bag or, more ideally, a hard case, as this supports the neck, body and headstock correctly, so there's no uneven pressure applied to any part, and the added insulation keeps the guitar at a more consistent temperature and humidity. After you finish playing or gigging, make sure to dry off any sweat, beer or other fluids with a cloth before you put the guitar back in its case. With electric guitars, you can keep a small bag of silica gel in the case to soak up any excess moisture. As I've just mentioned, if you've got an acoustic guitar, use a guitar humidification system, preferably the best one you can afford. And if you're transporting or travelling with your guitar where it might be subjected to more extreme conditions than usual, you know, hot cars and tour buses or maybe on a plane, make sure to loosen the strings off to relieve the tension on the neck before you travel, and always allow the guitar to acclimatise to a new environment for as long as possible before playing it. It's common practice for a lot of techs for bands playing at hot outdoor summer festivals to leave their guitars sitting in a rack backstage for at least a couple of hours before showtime to allow the guitars to settle and adjust to the conditions. So now let's move on to the don'ts. When it's not in its case, don't leave your guitar leaned up against a wall or other surface with all the weight being supported on the neck or headstock, as this will increase the possibility of a bent or warped neck. Avoid getting your guitar wet, and if you do, dry it off as soon as possible. Don't store your guitar next to a radiator, fireplace, drafty door or window. And don't leave your guitar in direct sunlight, because as well as attracting extra heat, the UV rays can also ruin finishes and plastic parts. Always avoid storing your guitar in a room which is subjected to either constant or extreme temperature changes, such as damp basements, garages, or in your attic or loft. And finally, never leave your guitar in the boot of a car for longer than necessary, either overnight or on a hot day. So that's how humidity and temperature levels can affect a guitar, and a few little tips on how to combat some of the problems they can cause. Now, due to the nature of their construction, this advice is especially important for acoustic guitars, but that doesn't mean that electric guitars and basses are immune from a lot of the problems that can be caused by more extreme temperatures and humidity levels. So before we finish up, let's just have a quick recap. The optimum relative humidity level for a guitar is between 45 to 55%. So aim to keep your guitar storage room between 40 to 60% to stay within safe boundaries. The ideal temperature should be kept between 21 to 25 degrees Celsius, that's 70 to 77 degrees Fahrenheit. So adjust radiator thermostats and your central heating controls accordingly, and get yourself a cheap digital humidity and temperature meter to keep an eye on those levels. If necessary, a dehumidifier or humidifier can regulate more extreme humidity levels, although they can be a little pricey. Clean your guitar regularly and store it in a hard case in a temperature regulated room, away from any heaters and out of direct sunlight. If you've got an acoustic guitar, invest in a good sound hole humidification system, such as the Daddario Planet Waves Humidity Pack. Try to avoid any extreme or rapid temperature changes, and be careful when transporting your instrument. Remember, just like dogs, guitars die in hot cars. Finally, it's completely normal for a guitar setup to need a little tweak every once in a while due to the neck moving slightly. But if you are worried that your guitar might be suffering from any problems caused by humidity or temperature levels, do bring it down to one of our stores and our experts will be happy to take a look. So thanks for watching. I hope that's helped. For more information on guitar humidification systems, visit pmtonline.co.uk or get down to your local professional music technology store. As always, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. That's PMT House of Rock. And if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please do give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. So thanks again. I'll see you next time.